वेलकम टू क्वेश्चन बैंक। टूडेज क्वेश्चन इज ए 500 मेगा वोल्ट एम्पियर टू 20 के वी 50 हर्ज अल्टरनेटर विथ एच टी इज इक्वल टू 1 पर यूनिट एंड एच टी डबल प्राइम इज इक्वल टू 0.2 पर यूनिट इज सप्लाइंग 400 मेगावाट पावर टू ए प्योर रेजिस्टिव लोड एट 20 किलोवोल्ट। The load is connected directly across the generator terminals when a symmetrical fault occurs at the load terminal. The initial RMS current in the generator in per unit is. This is the question. What are given? First thing is 500 megavolt ampere. This is the alternator and terminal voltage is 20 kV. And 50 hertz alternator with XT. What is XT? This is the synchronous direct access synchronous reactance. And another one is XD double prime. This is the subtransient direct access synchronous reactance. This is given. And this acts upon when the fault occurs. Only when the fault occurs. So I can draw here the circuit. Here is the alternator. And this is the reactance. This is the reactance. I am writing it XD. And this one is E. And here the terminal voltage is V. And this is supplying to a pure resistive load of R. And here current suppose is I. So here, as this is a pure resistive load and this is 400 megawatt. This is the power 400 megawatt and the resistance 400 megawatt is supplied to the resistance with the volt 20 kV. That means here the voltage 20 kV. Here the voltage 20 kV. So V square by R will be equal to the 400 megawatt. So R will be equal to V square by 400 mega. So this will be equal to what is V? V is 20 kV. That means 20 k square by 400 mega. So here k square means 10 to the power 3 square. This will be 10 to the power 6. So mega and 10 to the power 6 will be cancelled out, and here also 20 square is equal to 400 and this will be 1 ohm. So load is 1 ohm. And what is your Z base? Why we calculate Z base? Because everything here is given in per unit. So we have to calculate per unit values. So we have to calculate first what this load, this is load in per unit. So what is the Z base? Z base is kV square by MVA. This is the, what is kV square? This is base value and MVA base value. This is base value and base value. This will be 20 given 20 kVA by MVA. MVA value is given 500. This is the ratings. Ratings are given to be the base values. So this will be 0.8 ohm. So what will be the per unit resistance? R load per unit. This will be 1 by 0.8. That is R by Z base. This will be 1.25 per unit. This is load value. This is load. Here I can write this one is 1.25 per unit. So initial voltage, so here we have to find out E, because when fault occurs E will be supply the current, and here XT will be replaced by XD double prime. So what will be the E? We have to find out E vector will be simply equal to V vector plus I vector into J XT. Simple. and this will be v is taken to be 1 per unit, so 1 angle 0 plus 0.8 angle 0, this is the current, and here j 1.0, this is the xt value. And what is the current, how I am getting 0.8 current is here I will be equal to v per unit by r load per unit, so this will be 1 by 1.25, v is 1 and here this one is also 1.25, so this will be 0.8 per unit. As this calculation already done, I have neglected, so this is 0.1, and what we are getting, this is 1 plus j0 plus this one is 0.80 and multiplied with 1 angle 90, so this will be finally 1 plus j 0.8, and in polar form this will be 1.281 angle 38.66 degree. This is also in per unit value. E is 1.281 per unit. So when symmetrical short circuit fault occurs, then HT double prime comes into picture. What is HT double prime? This is the sub-transient synchronous reactance of D axis, direct axis reactance. So this will be, so fault current will be direct. What will happen in circuit? I am showing here is the circuit. What will happen here is the, suppose fault occurs, this will be short circuited, and here the fault current, here it will flow, and fault current will be given by, here the fault current will be given by, sorry, the fault current is given by E by J XT double prime. This will be 1.281 angle 38.66 by J 0.2, and this will be equal to 1.281 38.66 by 0.2 angle 90, so this will be 6.405 angle minus 51.34 degrees, and here this is also in per unit, so fault current will be 6.4 times that of general current. That is general current. What is then general current in case of load current? This is 1 per unit. Here this one is general current, but general current is current base is calculated from the V and R, and here the fault current is coming to be 6.4 times, that is 6.4 per unit. So thank you for watching up to here.